It is August 29th, 2013, and we are about to go see the Steve Jobs movie. Now, we are going to go see the Steve Jobs movie tonight at 9:25, and I thought I'd do a video about it just to kind of say my review. And then when I get back, I will give an official review, and it'll be really cool. When I do my review, I'll have the tripod and that set up, so it'll be a little bit more stable, but for right now, let's go.
Third time. The way I'm going to be rating my movies is if I give it a 5-star, that means go ahead and go pay the $13 and see it in theaters. If I give it a 4-star, that means pay the $5 on iTunes. If I give it a 3-star, that means Netflix. If I give it a 2-star, that means get it on DVD. If I give it a 1, that means watch it off a service, watch it off a free service on your computer, whatever. I don't care. Just on a free service or don't watch it at all. And the same will go with TV shows. The movie is about Steve Jobs, the CEO and co-founder of Apple, from his life from 1970-something to, I believe, 1976 to 2001 with the launch of the iPod. Now, my rating is, it wasn't the best movie, like I said in the beginning, but it wasn't the worst. Yes, the theater prices could have been a little bit cheaper, but I'm not talking about the theater, but I'll have to give it a 4-star. Now, that does not mean, so when it comes out on iTunes, I'm probably going to buy it. Well, I won't buy it on there. I'll probably buy it on DVD or Blu-ray. So, yes. But that just because I'm buying it on there does not mean I don't like it. This was a very good movie. Now, I did see some mixed reviews on Rotten Tomatoes and from other YouTubers such as Chris Perillo and a few others there. Actually, one video got taken down for that. But, I'm going to say go ahead and go out and see it in theaters, or go ahead and wait for it to come out on iTunes. I would say a lot of places it did. Not very many places had it in my area in Upper Canada. So, yeah, sometimes it's hard to find, but yeah. All in all, I'll give it a 5. So basically, you have a choice. You can either, if you watch the trailer, you have a choice to either see it in theaters, or you can wait probably about another 6 or 8 months and go watch it and wait for it to come out on iTunes. So yeah, this was a very good video, very good movie, sorry, and I really enjoyed it. Yes, there were some parts they mixed out. There was none, but I guess it only showed the whole part. It didn't show from when he was born and when he smoked marijuana and all that kind of stuff. But he did do acid, which that is in the movie. But all in all, it was a very good movie. I would see it again, but I'm not the type to go see a movie twice. It was extremely well. I will, again, get it on Blu-ray and DVD, just because I like to have those type of things. Although, if you do want to see a good Steve Jobs movie, go see The Pirates of Silicon Valley, which was a very good, I haven't seen it, but I've seen lots of good reviews. Actually might do another movie, TV show review on that. You never know. Although if you do want a good recommendation, there is two. One I can give you is The Lost Interview, which is available on Netflix. So if you have a Netflix subscription, you can go ahead and watch that. Lost Interview of Steve Jobs. Go ahead and, Steve Jobs, The Last Interview, which is from, which was right after Apple had started in the 70s. So, yeah. And another one would be Steve Jobs One Last Thing, which was recorded right after his death. If you're a book reader, you can also get the Steve Jobs biography by Walter Isaacson. Which, if you want, you can get that on Amazon for about $35, or you can go to audible.com and you can get a free book, and this could be your book. So, yeah. You can also get that book, the Steve Jobs biography, on iTunes for about $18. I guess they're kind of trying to make it a little bit cheaper. But for me, I'm more of an audio reader, because that way, personally, if I'm going on road trips or whatever, I cannot read on a car, on a plane, bus, whatever it is. So, I like audiobooks. Plug in some headphones, plug it into the car, and away you go. Anyways, guys, this is not an ad for Audible. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Click the like button down below if you enjoy it. And also, I guess now, the subscribe button is down below. Anywhere, actually. Mobile, computer. Yeah. So thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. Thanks for liking, commenting, and sharing all these videos. Now, don't say I stole that from Chris Perillo. I thought that was a good idea. So yeah. See you later. I guess. Here's the new closure. Peace. We're going back to it.